फाइव सेकेंड, टू सेकेंड, रेडी। आई एम ट्रूली डिलाइटेड टू बी हियर इन योर मिड्स टू सेलिब्रेट द 40th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ डिफेंस स्टडीज एंड एनालिसिस। आई एम पर्टिकुलरली हैप्पी दैट यू हैव चूजन ऑन दिस ऑस्पिशियस अकेजन टू ऑनर योर फार्मर डायरेक्टर फॉर हेल्पिंग टू ले अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फाउंडेशन फॉर दिस इंस्टीट्यूशन इन इट्स फॉर्मेटिव ईयर्स। हिज इंसिसिव राइटिंग्स कंटिन्यू टू स्टिमुलेट एंड कंट्रीब्यूट टू द थिंकिंग ऑफ स्ट्रेटजिक एनालिसिस एंड पॉलिसी मेकर्स इन दिस वाइटल एरिया ऑफ नेशनल कंसर्न। वी लुक फॉरवर्ड टू मैनी मोर ईयर्स ऑफ एक्टिव कंट्रीब्यूशन फ्राम दिस डोमेन ऑफ द स्ट्रेटजिक कम्युनिटी इन इंडिया टू द वाइटल पॉलिसी डिबेट्स ऑफ आवर टाइम्स। Over the years, he has pointed out in his writings the importance of making strategic choices that affect our national security and well-being by careful weighing of costs and benefits without getting trapped in black and white views of the world, ignoring the shades in between in which the real world manifests itself. He has been an ardent advocate of a holistic vision of national security tempered with a sense of realism and pragmatism. Let me therefore suggest that in keeping with our known principle on the need for long-term planning, we use this anniversary celebration to on strategic policy planning in general and on IDSA's contributions to this process in particular. On balance, I think it is fair to say that over the past four decades, IDSA has largely fulfilled its mission. While the existence of IDSA as one of our few strategic think tanks suggests a deeper need to create an adequately vibrant strategic community, this is perhaps a subject for study in its own right. Suffice here to say that I believe your institute has rendered great service often in difficult circumstances to promote strategic thinking, inform policy makers and the public at large, and to develop a community of strategic thinkers. I congratulate all those associated with this institute for contributing to strategic studies and institution building in a vital area of national concern. However, an anniversary is also an occasion to objectively consider the lessons of the past and to strategy to meet the challenges of our future. I would like to briefly outline the challenges that confront us today. It is a truism that despite the progress humankind has recorded war, disease, and ignorance, we can therefore draw no comfort from the trends that determine our future. Optimists suggest that the present security challenges will at worst persist, but pessimists forecast total devastation. Pragmatists suggest that security problems will worsen over time, but probably incrementally. Personally, despite my own training in the dismissal science of economics, I am inclined to be more optimistic than the optimists. Perhaps Bonarla was right when he said that there is no such thing as an inevitable war. If war comes, it will be from the failure of human wisdom. I believe that peace in our troubled and violent age requires internal vigil, patience, and wisdom. We must all work together to analyze potential sources of conflict to find solutions without recourse to arms. It is this that is the challenge before governments and humankind as a whole. It is in this context that centers of research and think tanks derive their importance. Policy making in most countries is often reactive. Governments are driven by deadlines and events. And once an event occurs, it is a bit late to plan for it. This is one reason why so many problems are difficult to resolve. Proactive planning is the goal of strategic thinkers worldwide, and this is where your community must step up efforts to identify problems, highlight trends, develop scenarios, and suggest policy options before crisis overtake us. I have often said and felt that there is a dearth of long-term planning. Of course, there is a saying of a very famous Cambridge economist, Lord Keynes, who said, "In the long term, we are all dead," but I do believe that there is a need for long-term planning. On the one hand, policy papers can sometimes become impractical, and on the other, policy options are sometimes short of long-term vision. Our academia loses its sense of independence, and government begins to devalue inputs from outside its system. There is therefore an obvious interest in strengthening mutual interaction to focus on long-term planning. In the language of economics, the cost of investing in long-term policy making in time, money, and energy are quantifiable and immediate. Unfortunately, however, the benefits are reaped only in future and all too frequently by successors. These benefits are also hard to quantify, since a crisis averted does not register on the popular consciousness. Naturally, the incentive for in-depth analysis and long-term policy planning has always been weak, despite the obviously disastrous consequences of ignoring such efforts. Having said that, let me elaborate my perspective of our security environment. There are those who define security solely in the narrow of violent conflict as only.